Saints, Prophetess Dawn O'Brien, servant of the Lord with Dawn's Heartfelt Corner here. I've not been on here for a very long time, and I felt led in my heart that God wanted me to do a video. We're almost, I'm telling you, God is getting ready to move. You know, I was up yesterday all day long from like 3:30 in the morning. I first woke up at 12:30. The Holy Spirit spoke to me. I went and wrote it down. Then I laid back down. I spoke again at 2 a.m. I mean, I wrote down what he said to me. And then again, I fell asleep. And then at 3:30, he said something else to me. Now, I'm not going to share all that with you, but he did tell me that, remember that dream about America's going to stand naked in front of the world? It's almost here. We're almost here. We're about to see an incoming optic, I don't know what you want to call it, a fireball, an asteroid, whatever. Whatever's coming is getting ready to touch down. Now, we keep going in and out. Now, I don't know, are we having problems? Because, you know, they always like to block me when I come on here. So let's pray. Somebody keeps coming on. I see it. So let's pray. Father, we come together as a body of believers, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that you're having me come here a long time now. Lord Jesus, I know you're getting ready to move, Lord. Father, we give you praise, we give you honor and glory, Lord. No fear, no worry, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. We put on the full armor of protection right now, the helmet of salvation, loins girded with truth, the breastplate of righteousness. We shod our feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace, and we take the shield of faith to quench our fire. It's the word of God. We commission your angels north, east, south, west, Lord. No fear, Lord. We are ready to march forward and do what you've called us to do, Lord. There are those waiting, literally waiting, Father, to come forth and speak. You've got them hidden behind closed doors. The enemy thinks he's coming through and doing what he's going to do, but you're going to put the new world order on us, upon us. Christians that are truly born again, in Jesus' name, amen. You know, we're going to go into that because, you know, I always want to be led by the Lord that he would speak through me, whatever it is. He wants me to say, we're going to worship in just a minute. But I put up a warning yesterday. Okay, and out here. Okay, I put up a warning yesterday. You know, a lot of times when I put these warnings up, nobody pays attention. Okay, I don't know if nobody believes something is coming or not. You know, yes, I've given warnings before on here. But I'm going to tell you right now, we're moving closer than we were in the past. You know, that's what a true prophet does. They warn, okay, when they see danger coming. Okay, in God's eyes, remember, one day is like 1,000 years. It hasn't been 1,000 years. So when I say this is going to happen or that's going to happen tomorrow, it hasn't been one day in God's eyes. So with the Lord, we've got time, okay? So it's coming, all right? And it's going to come when we least expect it. I told you that before. The Holy Spirit's been talking to me daily. I have dreams, visions, and words. I'm not making this stuff up. The Holy Spirit speaks to me. I relate to my dad. I don't speak a lot as much anymore on here, okay? I've got collages made. I'm getting ready to speak, okay? I know you don't believe that. Not just me, but there are other true prophetic servants that God has positioned to get ready to come forward and speak. And yes, President Trump is coming back, whether you believe it or not. I know that people think I'm crazy. President Trump is coming back. In fact, I found a prayer that I wrote him. In fact, I should read it to you. I'm going to show you this real quick. I saw this at Aldi. Look at this. It says, Lesser Evil Spaceballs. You see that? Everything to them, it has to do with space and aliens. Those are demonic spirits. They want you to believe that, oh, it's aliens. That's not what it is. And notice how it says lesser evil, okay? This whole world is covered with demonic spirits. I'm going to tell you, right? Witches, warlocks, that's what we're seeing right now, okay? Let's worship a few songs first, and then I'll get into what I want to say to you. Let's just worship a few songs. Turn this on. Hope you can hear it. Holy Spirit, we welcome. Just welcome the Holy Spirit. We welcome you, Lord. Awaken us. us, oh God.
Lord, we love
love you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Just as you are.
you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Amen, amen. We're going to have one more. Let's see. Breathe. I think I played these on Facebook the other day. I like this.
This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence in me. This is my daily breath. This is my daily breath.
I'm lost without you. I'm lost.
say something, you know. We here in America, you know what, I know a lot of people don't listen to me. I'm going to tell you something. And there might be people that don't like this, but it's true. You know, that song we were just singing about, I'm desperate for you. We here in the nation, we have everything, okay? We're not like these other countries that have nothing. And that's what's going to happen here in America. We're going to be like one of those third world countries where we're not going to know where our next meal comes from. Then we're going to be desperate for the Lord. You know, it's pretty sad that that's what it's going to take, because we don't seek the Lord. I'm going to tell you right now, the churches, everyone's going on and on like nothing's going to happen, but it is. And when that happens, that's going to be it. We're going to be desperate for the Lord. We need Jesus Christ now. Our world's a mess, and we're seeing it happen day by day. Things are happening, and it's going to happen here. You know, I give a warning on Facebook just yesterday, you know, and I said, saints, we're almost out of time. God loves us enough to warn us. If we do not listen to his correction, he will start judging, and that's what he's getting ready to do. There are those on here that call themselves a Christian and say they know Jesus. You know, and I'm not judging anyone, but I'm going to tell you, you can't just say Jesus, because was it Paul? One of the apostles talked about it. There's only one Jesus Christ that can do miracles and set souls free. There's going to be a lot of false prophets in these last days, so we have to be careful. You know, go read about that. One of the most dangerous verses in the Bible, I just stuck up yesterday. You know, because there are people sitting in the church that call themselves a Christian because they go to church or they sing in the choir. You know, the wheat and tares are mixed together. So we have to be careful that we associate with those, fellowship with those that God has chosen for us in these last days. You know, just like he was telling me, which I've shared before about salvation has come to homes, which in a minute I'll share that. But go look at that word, you know. Let me find these two scriptures. And I suck them up. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who deal truthfully are his delight. Proverbs 12:22. Because there are those, I'm just going to say, are those lying to the Lord and to deceive also the body of Christ. And we're going to have to watch out in the days ahead. And the Bible says in Hebrews 10:31, it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. So God sees. He sees all of us, saints. And I'm, like I said, I'm no better, okay? I'm here to give a word of warning. That's what God has placed in my heart. I don't want to do this because people think, oh, you're... No, I'm not. I've got sins of my own, and I have to worry about myself. But my job is to warn you, and so that you can warn others. And he has shown me things that are happening here in the United States, here in our world, and I'm going to have to speak soon. And some of them, I don't want to, but I don't have a choice. I have to do it, because my job is to warn you, and you're going to have to warn others, okay? Because we're going to have to watch out in the days ahead. It's not going to be safe to go anywhere anymore. I mean, we're going to have to watch where we go, what we do, because our whole world is getting ready to change. Let me see here. Now, also I gave a warning on the 26th, and I heard the Holy Spirit say this to me. Tomorrow is a day your world will change. Now, like I said, tomorrow, one day is like 1,000 days. 1,000 days is like, no, 1,000 years are like one day. One day is like 1,000 years to the Lord, okay? God's got all the time in the world. We're the ones that always want it now. We got to have it right this minute, you know, and we don't want to wait. I keep dropping this. I'm just going to move it over there, you know. So I don't want to wait. I get impatient. Like, my computer was slow yesterday, and I was on the computer, and it was so, I was getting angry, I was getting frustrated, and you know, saints, we're going to have to wait in this new season. I hate to say that, but we're going to do things differently. Things are going to have to be done differently. So we have to learn to be patient, and that includes me. We've got to be patient, we've got to walk in the fruit of love, peace, patience, the fruit of the Spirit. And you know, let me tell you something, we've got to be that way with others, okay? There may be days I'm not in a good mood. My dad may be, like, there are times we talk and he's not in a good mood and I'm not. You know, I keep to myself, you know. So there may be days People may not sleep a lot, and they may be grouchy, they may be irritable, short-tempered, or you might not be eating, you know? We may not be eating. I'm like, God, please don't let them ruin our plan. We're not gonna have any food. I mean, this is what's coming, saints. And nobody sees this. You can go over, I told you, to PNSN, okay? You can read about all the earthquakes there. ESPN or something like that, CSEM, which is by France, actually. All the earthquakes worldwide, all right? You can go to Space Weather, and they like say, always say, like, read about all that, and then they're always sending up another spaceship, you know, because they don't want you knowing what is actually going on, all right? So you can go there, do some research yourself. I told you, you need to do that. I've shown you fireballs that are going. You know what? I just saw one today that somebody saw. I don't know. I didn't print it out. Somebody saw it right over here where I live. And I was like, wow. You know, that made me a little nervous because that's the first one I've seen that someone saw it. Okay. And they said what didn't look like a normal shooting star. So they're going to start coming down. I don't know when, but they're going to start coming down. They're going to ruin crops. You saw, Daniel, I know, saw videos he sent to me and pictures of those tornadoes they had over in Nebraska and Iowa. Now, I was looking up, tornadoes are bad over in Missouri and in Illinois, okay? So, you know, things are happening all over. The weather is really bad. You can go over and read it on NOAA, N-O-A-A, the weather prediction. I'm always on all these sites. I check the power outages. Because remember I said we're going to lose power? And I'm always saying, Lord, I hope we don't lose power and connection, phone connection. That's going to happen, saints. It's coming. Okay? And, you know, this morning, I saw this on our Daily Bread, Angel Companions. And God brought me back to a message. In a minute, I'm going to read you. My children, you'll be in the company of angels. And I believe that's about to happen. Okay. Let me read you this Angel Companions on our Daily Bread. The scripture is Exodus 23:20. Now, by the way, we are still in the Passover, which I believe ends Tuesday. So God keeps saying to me, deliverance. Now, is deliverance coming right now? I'm like, okay, Lord, you know, he passed over the Israelites. So it could that happen right now? I'm not going to put it past God. Yes, it could. It could happen very well. Angel Companions. I'm sending an angel ahead of you to guard you along the way. Exodus 23:20. As medical tests, after medical tests, filled up Bev's schedule, she grew overwhelmed and weary. Doctors alarmed her when they told her they were looking for cancer or someone in her body. Each day, God faithfully encouraged her with a promise. And abiding peace when she turned to him or read the Bible. She battled with the uncertainties and frequently learned to roll the what-ifs onto God's shoulders. One morning, Beth came across a verse in Exodus 23 that popped out from the page of her heart before a serious surgery. I am sending an angel ahead of you to guard you along the way. Well, I believe, saints, we have angels. My dad's always telling me about how he's got angel of mercy, and I forget the other one. He's always telling me he can hear him writing, he says. So he tells me about the angels. But I believe we have angels, saints. Then it says, those words were spoken by God through Moses to his people, the Israelites. He was giving his laws for his people to follow and leading them to a new land. And I believe that we're getting ready to enter into a new territory here. But in the middle of those instructions, he told them he would send an angel ahead of them to guard them. Even though this wasn't Beth's life situation, she remembered that the care of angels is mentioned elsewhere in Scripture too, Psalm 91:11. He will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. And Hebrews 1:14 tells us God sends his angels as ministering spirits to serve believers in Jesus. If we know Christ, he's got an angel of angels near us to minister us as well. And I believe that, all right? We should read Psalm 91. That's one we should pray all the time, you know, that I believe Psalm 91 and Ephesians 6, putting on the full armor. Let's pray Psalm 91. Whoever dwells in the shelter of Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he's my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. We can't trust anyone else, so we got to trust the Lord. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say, the Lord is my refuge, amen, and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you. No disaster will come near your tent, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and serpent. You know, the Holy Spirit kept bringing this to me today. Maybe there are some of you, because I was reading that devotional about that lady that had cancer. Maybe you have a sickness in your body and you need God to heal you. Are you going through something right now? Maybe we should pray, all of us, you know, till more come together. You know, God is here. I believe we're about to see God do great miracles in these last days. So, Father, we come together as a body of believers, Lord. Just lay hands on wherever you're sick. Father, I pray for each and every one person on here that's listening, Lord, that is sick in their body, Lord. Father, there is nothing you can't do. You can do all things, Lord. So I pray for them, whatever it is that they're going through in their body, Lord. I speak healing over them in Jesus' name, from the top of their head to the soles of their feet, Lord, that they shall be healed, Father, and they shall go forth and share their testimony and tell others, Lord, look what the Lord has done in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Keep praying. Don't give up. You know, I don't know when these miracles are going to start, and I'm not saying every single person. No. I mean, whatever God wants to do, he's God, right? So we've got to let God just be God. But if we seek him and pray to him, I believe God is faithful. And he will take you are going through. You know, I mean, my dad right now has stomach problems. Okay. And I keep telling him, Dad, you've got to eat a certain way. You know, I'm not a doctor. You know, and I'm not a nutritionist. But I know, you know, it's kind of like, you know, I said, Dad, it's kind of like your car, right? You put gas in the car, you tune it up and fix it to make it run right. Well, if you don't put the right things in your body, it's not going to run right. All right? You don't eat your fiber, you don't eat your, drink lots of water, and take, you're going to have problems. And I tell them, yo, Dad, you're going to do these stomach exercises, you know, for your bowels. Hey, I know people say, you're going to talk about that? Yes, this is real. Oh, I got a whole thing on this. We're going to talk about this, saints, because, you know, if you don't eat right, especially in these last days, we're going to probably have to fast and pray now. I'm not expert in this fasting. I got to be honest. I'm trying to eat less, okay? And, you know, you're going to have stomach problems, yes. You may even feel a little nauseous sometimes. I know I feel like that. My dad feels like that. I feel, you know, remember in the Bible it says some of those spirits only come out by fasting and praying. We're going to have to fast and pray. That's what we're going to have to do in the days ahead. So, Lord Jesus, please help all of us, I pray. Amen, right? Let me share this word. Well, remember, I talked about a prophetic dream, America standing naked before the world. It's coming, saints. This is where I was talking about. Let me just share it to you. Early in the morning, this was back in 22. It was 2 years ago, 4/18/22. And the Holy Spirit just said this to me the other day. Okay, so it's like he brings back words that he spoke to me earlier. He reminds me of what's coming. Okay, excuse me. God is amazing because God will share, he has shared prophecies with me. We're talking years ago, and he'll bring them back. And it's like everything he said back then, it's like he keeps reminding me over and over. And God is so awesome, and I feel honored that he would speak to me like this and give me, but he'll do the same for you. God is not a respecter of persons. All he wants for each and every one of us is to humbly come before him and seek him, pray, and put him first, all right, in our lives. Now, this is everything I do. I don't go anywhere. This is what God has called me to do. I know people think, oh, I'm not doing anything. Yes, it's very hard waiting on the Lord following him, doing his will, hearing his voice, you know, because when he wants to talk to me, I have to be ready. You know, I told you a lot of nights I wake up during the night. I wake up during the night and I'll go in the bathroom and I have to write down what he says to me. You know, sometimes I don't get a lot, you know, now I'm tired, so I don't get up as much as I, but I got a feeling it's coming again. Mine is a witch's hour, I believe, very early in the morning. So I'll get up and I write down what he's saying. And sometimes he'll have me lay down, get back up again. Lay down, get back up again. And so finally, after I got up like 3 or 4 times, I'm like, oh, I better get up, you know, because he wants me up. All right, so I said this back in 1422, America Standing Naked. I had a dream that I was going to the doctor. You know me, I don't drive, okay? My brother-in-law was taking me to the doctor, and I was having a mammogram, and I don't like, in fact, Daniel's always nagging me about going, but I still haven't go. But you know, I trust God, he's gonna keep me healthy, and when he wants me to go, I'll go, all right? So my brother-in-law had taken me because he could only go on this one day, and there was the male doctor, and I didn't want to go, you know, but I went. The doctor I was going to see was not my usual physician, which is a female doctor. When I see a doctor, I like to say, if you look, because you're right, I'm in a physical, you know, you got to take off your clothes, you don't want to do that. So it feels awkward, you feel embarrassed, you know. So in my dream, I saw like the front headlines of a newspaper. I heard the Holy Spirit say to me in my dream, what does the enemy think he is fooling? Or no, who does the enemy think he's fooling? That's what I heard the Holy Spirit say to me in my dream. Then I instantly woke up. I said to the Holy Spirit, what does going to the doctor tomorrow, taking off my clothes, being nude, seeing those headlines have to do with what you just said? Who does the enemy think he's fooling? I then heard the Holy Spirit say to me, the United States is getting ready to stand naked tomorrow in front of the world. And that's what he said. I was like, wow. He said, it will be in national news because the headlines scrolled down in my dream like a front page of a news article. I was like, wow. So saints, I'm not making this up. This is what I heard. All right. I heard the Holy Spirit say, what is coming will make national news and the whole world will find out. You, my daughter, have warned. Now people will believe you, and all my true prophetic servants that have given them the warnings that you were not lying or fake. Now people will believe what you said was true. They will be in awe. Then I heard the Holy Spirit say, awestruck fear. This will be astronomical, never heard of in history, is what he said. Remember I said it's tantrum time? And I keep seeing in my emails, what is that? I see tantrum or the Democrats getting upset, you know. It's not about Democrats, Republicans. It has nothing to do with that. It was never about that, okay? They want you to believe that it's about that. They have been covering deep and dark secrets for a very long time. Now, I'm not going to say it on here. There are a lot of things I know, okay, that the Holy Spirit has said to me very early morning. My husband is still dealing with demonic spirits. He's getting better. In fact, he's almost healed now. Okay, and I praise the Lord that he's almost healed. He's going to share his testimony. There's going to be others. I've told others on here. Come forward. If you're dealing with something, or if when it comes time, you're dealing with something, you come forward and speak. God will protect you. Okay, there are people here that I know that are, don't say anything. And I know I'm not going to be talking on the phone for long. The Holy Spirit already told me that. I'm going to have to watch what I say. We're all going to have to watch what we say and what we do. Okay? There's enemies here. There's spies in this country. There's terrorists. It's not just inside. It's outside. It's on the borders. Criminals. All right? That's all I'm going to say. We're going to have to watch what we say and where we go, what we do. Okay, so, I have to do this. I don't want to, and people are going to know about me. They're going to know, because I always say I'm getting ready to spill the beans. Ugh. I don't want to, but I have to. You know why? Our freedom. And I've said this before, our freedom is in danger. Maybe you don't realize that yet. You know, there are, everybody, not paying attention, and they don't even know what's happening with the weather, okay? So there's more going on than meets the eye. You don't go by what you're hearing on the news. That's the news media is fake. Fake news has nothing to do with that. They want you to think it does. I'm going to tell you, when things start happening, people are going to be lost. They're not going to know what's going on. That's why God said us bright beacons are going to have to be a light. Share the gospel. Help them. Because they're not going to know. Bring them to the Lord. They're going to be lost. They're going to be people that want to commit suicide. God showed me that the other day. They're going to want to end their life. There's always going to be torment or harassed by demonic spirits. Daniel's had that harassed. Okay, not as bad as it's going to be. Because the portals of hell are coming up. And yes, they're going to open the portals of hell. I've tried to tell others that they think I'm crazy. But we're not going to think it when it happens. Okay? But if you're sealed in Jesus Christ and you know the Lord and you're not lying and you're a true disciple of Jesus Christ, and you're walking with him daily, then you don't need to worry. Okay, maybe you're on here right now, I'm talking to you. Let's just pray, you know, because I want to be led by the Lord. If you're and you're lying, or if you maybe you've been living a lie, because I'm going to tell you right now, I'm just going to come out and say it, okay? I wasn't planning on saying it. There are those on here that may be transgenders, okay? There may be those that are saying they're a Christian, but they're, and maybe they truly do believe in Jesus, okay? But they are transgenders. I want you to know God loves you. Come out clean. Just come out and be who God created you to be. I know it may be embarrassing for you, but it's going to happen because God has already told me the masks are going to come off, all right? And we have to love one another, accept each other. For whatever happens, I mean, I'm not perfect. I got my things, and now he's gonna shove me out there. And I'm like, God, why are you putting me out there? You know, because I'm just gonna tell you, I have a big mouth, and I'm like, God, you're putting the wrong person out there. Daniel and I fight like cats and dogs, and I'm like, Lord, we're dealing with issues here and now, and I'm like, that's why I don't want people around us either, you know. And you're gonna stick us in the front. I'm like, Lord, they're really going to be talking about us. And we're going to have to go out there. But you know what? We all have something. I don't care who you are. Maybe you think you're better. No, you're not. We're all sinners. By God's grace and mercy, we all have something. But God wants us to confess our sins to the Lord. Maybe I'm talking to you and God is dealing with you. And he's been dealing. Maybe you want to run away. Maybe you feel like running away and hiding. You don't know what to do. Well, I'll tell you who knows what to do. Jesus Christ knows. He'll show you. He'll give you wisdom and direction of what you need to do. But come clean before the Lord. Now, I plead with you. And I've said this before. If you're on this Facebook website, if there's anybody on here that is not being true to the Lord, maybe you're siding with the enemy. Maybe you're doing things for money. Yeah, there are those that are getting paid off by China. Now, I just said it, yes. And you're doing things, coming under the rug so nobody knows. You know who knows? Jesus Christ knows. Okay, you can't say, oh, I love you, Jesus, and then do things behind closed doors. He knows your heart. What's your motive? What are you doing it for? God sees. And that goes for me. Our motives have got to be pure and holy before the Lord now. Because he said, awestruck fear. That means we're not going to be able to lie to the Lord. And that includes me. Remember Moses? The sick. And I'm like, God, what if I get angry? You know what I mean? Am I going to go home? You know, that's scary. We serve a holy God. Our God is holy. And he expects you and I to live holy lifestyles. We can't lie. There are those on here that may talk about being gay or this, but yet they're gay. Or they're living a different lifestyle, but they're lying about it, and they don't want you to know, and they want to see the body of Christ. Shame on you. Repent, says the Lord. Repent. There are those I know that are not doing what God's asked them to do. And we can't ask God to do miracles and watch over us and our families if we're not doing what's right. That means all of us, there's things in our heart and our lives. Lord, purify us. Get us right if there's anything on us, Lord. Forgive us, Father. Just pray that to the Lord. Say, God, forgive me. I've sinned against you. There are things in my heart that aren't right, Lord. I confess them before you, God. Change me, God. Mold me. Make me into your image. Make me what you want me to be, God. I may think this is the right way, but Lord, your ways are not my ways, Lord. Help me to do your will, God. I want to follow you all the days of my life. Pray that from your heart. Be sincere. You know, God told Daniel the other day when he prays for someone, sincerely pray. You know what? I started doing this, you know. And maybe this is where I'm used to always doing everything, you know. You know, because I call my father in the morning, you know, and we pray. They're always wanting me to pray. And I said, Dad, I can't always pray. I need you and Daniel to pray. So I called on Daniel the other day. You know, and he tells me, he listens to this pastor, I forget the name of it. And he said, the wife picked on, Pastor Jared picked on him to pray. And, you know, because he's a quiet one normally, and she's the one that's bold, you know, and that's like me. I'm very bold and very outgoing, you know. Daniel's the quiet one. So now I'm, Daniel, you need to pray. Or if something needs to be done, Daniel, I want you. And his mind's not clear right now all the way. But you know what? I'm learning to say, okay, Daniel, you do it. I don't want to do it. I'm tired. And God's getting me prepared to do other things. And I said, God, help me be the submissive wife. Let Daniel do what he needs to do. Come up higher. Because for years, I didn't let Daniel. And, you know, God's changing me. He's changing all of us. You know, and, you know, I'm not this quiet little mouse, you know. I'm very bold, very strong, you know. So, you know, God's made us all different. Lord, you know, what does it say? Opposites attract. You know, I guess Daniel, he's different than I am. You know, we're both different. So, and I love my dad. I said, you know, my dad's coming back to Florida. And I said, but we're waiting on God. He's right now cleaning out my grandmother's house. And we're waiting for God to do it at the right appointed time. But I want my dad, I haven't told you, Dad, if God will bless you with your own place, I'd like you to have your own place unless you need me to help you. Because me and my father clash. We're too much alike. We're both Italian. And I really, honestly, right now, don't want to live with my dad right now. I mean, Daniel and I have enough to God's always telling him, work on your marriage, you know. So we're trying to get things right between us still. The Lord is working on us. And I believe he's working on a lot of couples, you know. Because if you live in the same household with your husband, yes. You may sit in separate rooms. I remember speaking on YouTube. This lady used to tell me all the time, her husband or her sit in separate rooms. Dan and I did that. That keeps us from fighting. And I believe a lot of people are going to have to do that because of what is coming. We're going to have to just, you know, pray for one another too. You know, we can't follow them. If that husband or that wife does this and you don't feel the Holy Spirit is telling you to do it, then you pray and love them. Let them be themselves. Don't try to change them. I don't need to change Daniel, and Daniel don't need to change me. We need to be ourselves. Let God do the changing, right? We're all doing that. Me, I'm saying that because it's for me. I don't need to tell Daniel what to eat. He needs to know. If he don't want to take care of his body, I can't tell him how to take care of me. Just like my dad, I can't tell him. All I can do is focus on what God's told me to do because I'm going to answer to the Lord. The same goes for you. You're going to answer. Don't worry about that person over there. Don't worry about your husband, your wife, your children. Yes, there are some of you taking care of your children. Has God told you to? You're doing more harm than good. Do what the Holy Spirit is telling you. The parent can help the child too much. Okay? So do what he's telling you to do. If God's telling you, I don't want you to help them, you know, sometimes they may need to learn the hard way. That prodigal son or daughter may need to fall. And then it's going to come back. You see what I'm saying? We have to leave everything in the Lord's hands. See, now I told you, I started speaking the Holy Spirit, and he gets the glory. Okay, now I'm getting hot. And I don't have another fan in here. All right, that's one thing I need. That's my pet peeve. I get hot. You know, this weather is so crazy. You know, my dad, Yesterday in Chicago, it was, he's telling me it was windy, warm. It was like 80 degrees. It was windy and cool here last night. It was in the 70s, I think. But then he's had it where there's been snow. So it's like it goes back and forth. It's really strange all over. But, you know, they're messing with our weather, okay? We talked about the CERN. I'm not going to get into all that. Over there in Geneva and Switzerland. That was right after the Queen died. I noticed it. When I walked outside, there's a planet. I showed you a picture. There is a planet out there. And people are going to start seeing it, okay? I believe that planet is what's affecting some of our weather. I believe that, okay? So, let me see what else. Okay, now, here, maybe I'll read this. Salvation has come to homes. I just really wanted to just get on here and just maybe just speak, you know, because I haven't spoken in a while. And because I know I'm going to be speaking soon. So it's good practice for me, whether there's anybody on here or not. Thank you for those that are on here. You know, I wrote this word in 8:10:23. Salvation has come to home, so I'll share this with you. At 6:06 a.m., I just finished writing a prophetic word about the Diamond Head Hawaii volcanic cone. You know, and they've been swarming over there. I told you, in different places. Hawaii, you're not seeing only on the backside of the sun. You're seeing places like Texas, yeah, Oklahoma, Hawaii's been swarming. I saw some in Puerto Rico. Could that be up because of what is coming? We're getting ready to see. Okay, so I just finished doing a prophetic word on that, and suddenly out of nowhere I heard the Holy Spirit say, "My children, you are entering a time of great sorrow." And I called this salvation has come to homes. Do not fear, my little ones, those of you who have been trusting and walking with me, the Lord. I will hide you away, I hear the Holy Spirit say, into my secret place where no evil will touch you. I, Lord, will surround you with my angels. Fear not. I heard the Holy Spirit say it loudly, so I tackled. I, the Lord, am in control of heaven and earth. What comes next is in my hands. Trust me. See, so you and I have got to trust the Lord daily. Okay, he may not show us what's ahead of us, okay, but we're walking like baby steps. We have to trust God every single day. He said, today is a day of transformation. That is also my daughter when Daniel will go from Saul to Paul. And he told me that before, and I've been seeing changes in Daniel. Daniel's been changing. We're all changing. Say, if you're truly walking with God, you're going to change. If you're not changing, you better ask yourself, are you doing the right thing? Are you walking right with the Lord? Because when you're walking, you're going to change. All right? I heard him say, I'll become a mighty man of God like Daniel the prophet, is what he said. I was like, wow, that's what I heard the Holy Spirit say to me. Anticipate what I will do, my children. Do not fear me, says the Lord. Come close to me. Do not be afraid like the children long ago were afraid to even come near Moses. Keep going in and out. I don't know what that is, if they're having problems or they're just blocking my video. But that's okay. You know, God's here. We're not going to get upset. See, the enemy wants me to get upset, but I'm not going to get upset. All right, because I know my time is coming. I'm going to be delivered out here, and he's going to put me in a place where I'm going to speak and no devil in hell is going to stop what God has called me to do. And same goes for you, all right? If you're following the Lord and you're doing him, no devil in hell is going to stop what he's got for you, okay? So don't think God has forgotten you or left you or doesn't care. He does, okay? Remember, his timing is not like ours, so we may have to wait. And I told my dad that. You may not come back to Florida right this second. You know, he's got a year at my grandma's house. Grandma gave my dad a year. And that's God. God gave my dad a year. And while they're going through the house, and maybe that's God doing that, because our economy's getting ready to go down. That, and they're going to have like a sale, and they're going to sell my grandma's house and make money. I said, Dad, that may be God doing that. That may be God doing that because of what is coming. So I know God has a perfect timing for everything. All right. Do not be afraid like the children long ago who were afraid to even come near Moses, my servant. I told him to take off his shoes. He's standing on holy ground. You, my children, are getting ready to stand in my presence, not literally in heaven, down here on earth. And I believe that. We're going to be surrounded with his angels. I, the Lord, will envelope you, is what I heard the Holy Spirit say. I'll put a hedge of protection around you on all sides where no evil can touch you. For my angel, says the Lord, will give charge over you, which we just read. Psalm 91. Then in the spirit, I see and hear wails of people crying. Devastation, I hear the Holy Spirit say, is coming. The word prune, I hear the Holy Spirit say. Prune your hearts now, my children, from anything that will stand before me, says the Lord. That's why I said we've got to ask God, take what's in us out, whatever's not of him. Do it now. Don't wait. All right, he said, I'm coming to judge the living and the dead. Be strong, says the Lord. The time is short. I'm speeding up time before I, the Lord, return. Encourage your brothers and sisters. Help out the weak and downcast. Be a light wherever you go. Shine for me, Jesus Christ. Soon, I'm coming in the clouds. But we've got to remember, our soon is not God's soon. Because every time he tells you, I'm getting out of here, we're still here. I have been packed up. Seriously, saints, for years. Ask Daniel, he'll tell you. My stuff is packed. I'm ready to go. I've been ready. So God's timing is not like ours, all right? I heard the Holy Spirit speak. Never forget how much I love you. I am not doing this to punish you, he said. I'm doing this because I love you. You know, and that's what a father does. You know, your earthly father disciplined you, right? When you were younger. I don't know, maybe you didn't have a dad. My dad disciplined me. We all came to belt. If we didn't do what's right, we got disciplined. And nowadays, kids don't get any discipline. We're not talking about beating the kid. That's not what I'm talking about. My aunt gave my cousin a little switch on his feet, on his leg, you know. We're talking about a little discipline, a little spanking, all right? What does the Bible say? Discipline the child if you spare the rod, right? You know, so God does not want us to not discipline the children. Look at it now. We've got a generation that nowadays we do whatever we want to do. And they don't care. Nobody cares. Parents aren't even watching their kids. I mean, where I live right here, I've seen kids outside when it's getting dark already. And me, we had to get home. My dad would say, you be home before it gets dark. Nowadays, I see kids out here when it's already dark. They're out here. I'm like, and not another thing is I see kids right by the road. Little kids that are, I don't know, seven, eight, real small. And they're even going to the grocery store for their mother. Or they're putting the garbage. And they can't reach the bin, so they stick it down the bottom. They don't like that where we live. The parents are either too tired or lazy. And I think a lot of parents may be tired because they're having to work. Some of them work two jobs just to provide for their family. Meanwhile, we're giving all the money away to other countries and helping, excuse me. I'm going to grab a drink. We're giving all this money to foreign countries. And then we're teaching others, the ones that can work, you don't need to work anymore. You can become an entrepreneur, be on the cover, sit in your cave and smoke pot. Yeah, that's what they're doing. I've seen it. I'm not going to share it all right now, but yeah, I've seen it. That's what they're teaching the young people. No longer go to work. You want to know why? So our economy can go down. We have no economy, no nothing. They want us to be like a third world country. But is anyone going to speak up? I will. You know, God needs more of us to stand up and speak truth. We cannot worry what man says if they like us or don't. Oh, well, you don't like me? Too bad. I'm doing what God's asked me to do. All right? We can't worry. They're going to persecute you. They're going to persecute me and say, oh, she's got a head injury. She don't know what I got to learn to ignore it. God told me, he gave me a cup. I'm going to have it right here. I got a cup, a mug. God is so awesome. I was at the Goodwill, you know. I found this mug. And if this isn't God, I don't know what it is. It says something about state your business, walk away quietly. State your business, walk away quietly, and no one will get hurt. I was like, wow. You know, when it comes time for me to speak, state my business, say what the Holy Spirit tells me to say. Don't answer back when they persecute you or say something. Don't fight with them. Walk away quietly. Remember Jesus? He didn't answer them back. He turned, we're to turn the other cheek. You know, that's not all easy, right? But we can get ourselves in trouble if we run our mouth. And all we're doing is adding fuel to the fire. So we got to shut up. Lord, help us zip our tongues. Help me, God. I'm Italian. I'm bold and very strong. Go to get the Lord's word. Right? You know, Jay has become Italian. Jay is Irish, but he's become Italian. You got to get that last word. You know, but anyways, no, God wants us to be quiet. My dad's a mouse. He's pretty good. My dad, he's easier not to get along with than I could. Because I think, you know, the older you get, it mellows you. Then you won't fight as much. I think that's what it does. Anyways, all right, we got to have a little humor. You know, I don't have this. I should have brought these things that we gotta have a little lighten up, right, saints? Because it can't be. I'm serious. You're talking to someone that doesn't lighten up. Daniel always tell me lighten up because I'm too serious, you know. And I never had a childhood. You know, for those that don't know, you know, I grew up. I never had a childhood. My mother died when I was 13 years old. You know, I grew up without my mother, my dad, you know, so my father was very rough, you know, so I didn't have a mother. And so I had to grow up fast and I become serious, you know, so this is, you know, my time to lighten up and be a child. But anyways, I saw this thing, what was it? Something about Fantasy Island with Obama and, Fantasy Island with Obama and Joe Biden, and it said, the plane, boss, the plane, or something like that. It was cute. I wish I had that. I could show it to you. It was real funny, though, you know, and so, but anyways, it's good to have a little laughter. What does it say? Laughter is good medicine, the Bible says. So we've got to laugh, and we've got to praise God, you know, and not be stressed so much. Stay on here. All right, so he said, the Holy Spirit was speaking to me about the salvation has come to homes, and he said things to me. He said, never forget how much I love you, so He wants you and I to know that He loves us. What's getting ready to happen is not to punish us saints. He's doing it because He loves the Father, disciplines you that because He loves you. And that's what our Heavenly Father is going to do. It's because He loves us. Okay, so don't look at it as at Him punishing you. Okay? I said, that is what a good father does. He disciplines you. I don't want any of my children to be judged. Repent now, says the Lord. Turn away from this world because everything in this world is evil. Seek me, the Lord, for true meaning of the word of God. I, the Lord, will teach you through my Holy Spirit. I place many spiritual gifts in each of you, my children. And He has. You know, we're all different, saints. You might not have the same spiritual gift as somebody else, okay? You know, maybe you can't speak or you can't sing. I can't sing. I wish I could, but that's not my gift. You know, and I can't drive. I need helpers to help me. You know, so we all work together in the body of Christ. All right. So your gift is just as important as somebody else. Maybe you're called to pray. Maybe that's all God is called. There are people. My dad and I were talking about the other day. Prayer warriors. That's all they do is pray all day long. Now, I couldn't do that. There are people that can. That's what their gift is, though. So, and maybe your gift is preaching, maybe, like I said, maybe your gift is worship, an instrument, singing, you know, whatever your gift is, do it as unto the Lord, pleasing to God, all right? He said, use those gifts, he said. Those gifts have become dormant. There are Christians here that have gifts, and they become dormant. Use those gifts for the Lord's glory. Do them now. Ask God to anoint you and use you for His glory, and He will. All right? Go and share the good news with every man, woman, child, and tongue. And that's what He said to me. All right. All right, saints. So, I think that's it. I just wanted to tell you, you know, and, you know, I'm not speaking judgment on anyone or doing anything, but I had a dream about Joe Biden I told you about. Okay? The Holy Spirit gave that to me, and it's not me, okay? We need to pray for Joe Biden. We need to pray that he turn his heart to the Lord, because I had a dream back in on March 3rd that he had passed away. He died. The dream was so real. what do you call it? Like with his heart. I can't think of it right now. I don't have that. But it was showing me that a long time ago. I have prophecies written on that. Okay. In this dream, it was so real. I heard ambulance and sirens and a lady giving the news. Then I heard family members from the family members in the background crying. There were cars in front of the White House. This was during the night. I saw lights on the outside of the White House. Then the newscaster came on the air and said that Harris does not know anything yet. Then I instantly woke up at 6 a.m. Now, the Holy Spirit has shown me that Harris is going to sit in the office for a little while before President Donald Trump comes back. I know people think that's, but the Holy Spirit told me he's literally going to put him there, okay? Because something major is coming. So he's literally going to be put in office. Biden's going to be taken out, him and his administration. And this is what the Holy Spirit's going to do. I know they think I'm crazy. Well, that's them. You know, but I know, and I'm going to stand by what the Lord said. In fact, I'm going to read you this prayer when you find it. I wrote a prayer to President Donald Trump when he was in office. Here's a picture of him. Jesus. Somebody made that picture. But I'm going to read you. I wrote a prayer for President Trump back in 2017. That's how long it's been, saints. Let's see. What is that? This is going on the seventh year. 9/29/17, I wrote this. And I'm going to read this to you. Holy Spirit is so amazing. He keeps bringing me back to this stuff. So I wrote this. I said, Dear President Donald Trump, God has sent warnings to America time and time again of what is about to take place. As Commander-in-Chief, it's time you lead America back to God, who is the only true help for our fallen nation. America has had Christian presidents in the past. God is raising you up today to lead America, I hear the Holy Spirit say. Dear Heavenly Father, I pray you give the Trump administration wisdom and direction to help lead the United States of America in these perilous times we are living in. Surround President Donald Trump with godly men and women that you have chosen to help lead. To help him lead America in the coming days. Thank you, dear Lord. We can always come to you with a contrite and humble heart. You hear our prayers in Jesus' name. Holy Father, I pray for President Donald Trump and I lift him up to you in Jesus' name that you make him strong, steadfast, and immovable to overcome the obstacles we as a nation will face. We are more than conquerors in Christ. While you, with you on our side, we can scale a wall. There is nothing we cannot do when you are on our side. Apart from you, we can do nothing. He gave me Psalm 18, 29 to 31. For by you I can run against a troop, but my God I can leap over a wall. As for God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord is proven. He is a shield to all who trust in him. For who is God except the Lord? And who is a rock except our God? Thank you, Holy Father, for mercy. We call upon your name, Lord Jesus, to help us. You promised us to be near us in a time of need. Lord, we need you more now than ever before. Rescue America today and help them in their time of need, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. And Psalm 18:6. In my distress, I called on the Lord and cried to my God for help. He heard my voice and out of his temple, and my cry for help before him came into his ears. And that's what I prayed. And I said, God, you are so awesome. So God has a timing, saints. He has a timing for everything. There's no fear. We don't need to be afraid. I know I've gotten nervous because I don't know what's happening. But we have to be strong. We have to hold our head up high. And we're going to have to encourage others, saints. Okay, so let's pray as we leave. You know, we're getting ready to enter our new week. This is the week, I believe, when Passover ends. And then we go into May. Now, is something going to happen? I don't know. We're just going to continue to wait. And that's what we're to do. Wait. So let's pray. Father, we come together as a body of believers again, Lord, as we get to ready to leave, Lord. I pray that you watch over all of us, Lord, and keep us safe in the coming days, Lord, this week, Lord. I don't know what's coming, only you know, Lord. But we trust you. We walk by faith and not by sight, Lord. We take one day at a time. We're not worried about tomorrow. We think, what more important are we, Lord? You promised to take care of us, Lord. You promise to watch over us, Lord. We don't look to man. Man can't do anything, Lord. But we turn our eyes and our heart towards you, Lord. And we ask that you would help us, Father. Help us. Give us grace. Give us strength. Give us mercy to endure. We're going to have to, cast out spirits, Lord. I believe that's coming, Lord. No fear. Give us grace and strength to do what we have to do. Holy boldness, Lord. Stand strong for you, Lord. Speak truth in these last days. I believe you are those you're calling for in this hour that runs for you, Lord. We thank you for meeting all of our needs according to your riches and glory, Lord. Providing for us, Lord. Help your people not to worry, Lord. Not to focus on anything else but you, Lord. Take each day as it comes and look to you, Lord, for wisdom and guidance, Lord. And we ask you to go with us today and this week and every day. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. All right, saints, I want you to know we love you. We're praying for you. Please keep us in your prayer. If you can help us, I might put that up there. We haven't got any help, but I know it's coming. If you can help us, if you can give a gift, we are 501c3, tax deductible. If you have a large gift and want to receive, we can send that out to you. All right? Be safe. I know I come on and come off, you know, but I believe now we're getting, I know I keep saying that, but you know what? Like I said, one day to the Lord is like a thousand years, like one day. And when, I know people are saying we're going home, there's going to be a nuclear war. Those explosions are going to be volcanoes around the ring of fire. They're going to wake up, okay? So we're entering into a new earth, new season. We're not all going to die. There will be people that will pass away, yes. Maybe people you heard of, maybe people you never even heard of. Even politicians, yes, famous people. Okay, so I've said this before, it's coming. Fault lines are going to break, volcanoes are going to wake up, witches have been chanting. This is what they want to see happen. That's why we've got to constantly put on the full armor of protection every single day. When you walk out that door, do not leave your home without putting the full armor on. All right? I want you to know we love you, all right? So be strong. Keep your eyes on the Lord. And keep us in prayer if you can. All right? Until we meet again, Prophetess Dawn O'Brien. God bless y'all. I've got to figure out now how to turn this off.